The works we were asked to look at were part of a wider scheme which involved the demolition replacement of the external structures between Durnford House, which is a boarding house for the students, and the school hall in the college memorial buildings. Primarily, it was to refurbish the inside where they had a lot of asbestos, which they needed to get rid of, but also to install a hydraulically operated floor, which meant the floor could be lowered for various functions and then reinstated afterwards to give them more floor space. The area of existing basement in front of the stage is being lowered by, I think, 1.2 meters to accommodate the hydraulic floor, sorry, the lift for the floor. There you can see the, prior to demolition, that's the existing school hall floor. And underneath that is a series of vaults and a basement. When I say a basement, it's about 1.2 meters high in headroom. So the proposed construction involved reducing the level of the basement. However, where the foundations of the columns came down, there was concern over load transfer into the excavation, i.e. the zone of influence beneath the existing foundation projected into the proposed dig. So we were asked to grout, or the engineer came up with a grouting scheme, and we offered an alternative with geopolymer to inject beneath the existing foundation to remove the load, or the potential for load transfer into the excavation. In addition, the water table is very close to the underside of the proposed slab, so they asked us to inject into the area to be excavated to stop the potential of any groundwater ingressing into the excavation. There were six columns with associated foundations on the perimeter of the excavation, which we needed to treat to increase the angle of internal friction and to remove the potential for load transfer into the excavation. And then there was an area where they were reducing the level, or where they're going to reduce the level, in the front of the stage, where we injected beneath the existing slab down to a level to permit the excavation and installation of the new floor slab and walls. Okay, so the school hall is located between Durnford House, which is the boarding school, or the boarding rooms, and the library building, which is the building on the right, the cupola, behind which you can see part of the college. Access was very, very restricted, and it was necessary for us to park on the high street. We're approximately 75 meters away from where we were injecting. As you can see, we were able to work around the demolition of the existing basement, installing the tubes for the injection beneath the existing basement slab. This is a photograph of the foundation that was exposed, foundation beneath the column that was exposed after treatment. And you can see there the stone corbel, which we drilled through and treated the ground beneath. The markers on the wall, precise level survey, so when they excavate it, they'll be able to monitor any movement of that column.